Hey everybody, welcome back to the MacWhisperer Academy. I'm Dylan Stewart, the MacWhisperer. And if you've ever gotten frustrated trying to figure out how to digitally sign a document, then this lesson was made just for you. Let's hop on in and get started. Don't you hate it when somebody emails you a document that you have to sign? You have to print it out and then sign it by hand, and then what? Then what are you supposed to do? You're supposed to scan it back into the computer or take a picture with it on your phone and text it to them? It's so frustrating and complicated. You would think by now there would be an easier way to do it. And in truth, there is. Apple created a program called Preview that has been a part of their operating system for years. It's the default program on your computer that opens up both JPEGs and PDFs. And it can be amazingly valuable for editing, cropping, or marking up image files. If you missed my walkthrough on how to use Preview for image files, click on the upper right corner and go check out that lesson. In this lesson, we're going to focus on how to use Preview with PDFs. First off, let's hop over to the computer where I've got a couple of PDF files waiting on my desktop for us to play with. We're going to start by double-clicking on this file here and opening it up in Preview. Now that we've got that PDF opened, I want you to notice the toolbar across the top. The first thing to pay attention to is this little sidebar icon that you see in the upper left corner. Most people don't know it's there at all, and it's one of the most valuable parts of Preview when you're dealing with multi-page PDFs. Now, if your PDF is just one page long, you don't really need to worry about this. But when you're dealing with a document with more than one page in it, or hundreds of pages, this is critical. I'm going to go ahead and click the caret to the right side and select where it says thumbnails, and you'll see that sidebar open up on the left with a small thumbnail of every single page of this document. The sidebar is so valuable because right from the sidebar, you can reorganize the pages of a PDF like this. Simply click on any one of those pages and move it to any other location. It's also really easy to delete pages right from the sidebar. All you have to do is click on any page and hit the delete button on your keyboard like this, and poof, that page is gone. The other thing that you can do with the sidebar that's really helpful is you can add and import pages from other PDFs. All you have to do is take that document, and in this case, we're going to look at this one-page document that I have on the left side here, and just drag it where you want it to go. Let's put this at the top of this document. So I'm going to drag it in, put it right into page one, and release it. And just like that, I can combine multiple PDF documents into one larger PDF, just like you can do with Acrobat. Now, to the right side of the toolbar, you're going to notice the zoom out and zoom in buttons here. Let's go ahead and zoom in or zoom out. To the right of the zoom in and zoom out buttons, you're going to notice our share icon. The share icon is always the easiest way to send out any kind of document. It gives you options for emailing, for text messaging, for airdropping, for adding a document into your notes program, or even sharing it and collaborating on it with another Apple user. To the right of that, you'll see the highlight tool. By clicking on the caret to the right of that, you can choose what color. We're set on yellow right now. And anything that I select will immediately get highlighted. You can even use the highlight tool to add underlines or strikethroughs to your document if you need to. To the right of that, we've got the rotate tool. The rotate tool is really helpful if you've scanned in a page and you accidentally scanned it in the wrong direction. For example, if we look over to the thumbnails at the left, you'll notice that the document I dragged into this PDF is sideways. That doesn't look right. We're gonna need to fix that. But I don't have to rescan the document. All I have to do is select the page that's turned the wrong way on the sidebar on the left, and then click the rotate button, just like this. And all of a sudden, I'm done. And to the far right, you'll find the magnifying glass. This will allow you to search for anything in the entire document. You can't underestimate how valuable this tool is on a really, really, really long document. I mean, you might be looking for that particular part of the contract that refers to your compensation. Or, in my case, let's find everywhere in this document where the word men comes in. And if you look at the sidebar on the left, you can see how many times it shows up on each page. In fact, on page one, it shows up twice. And if we zoom in a little bit, we can see that it's highlighted those two sections. And on page two, it's shown up five times. We can see it all over the place. When you're done searching, you can hit the little X in the far right side to cancel that search out and go back to your document as it is. Now, if that was all that you could do with Preview, it would still be a pretty good program and probably enough for most people. But you and I are not most people. So we're going to unlock the superpowers of this app by clicking on the markup tool that we see on the far right side here. Clicking on this button drops down a toolbar that has almost limitless capabilities. On the far left, we can select text just like this so that we can copy and paste it into another document. Or right here, I can redact sections of this PDF easily in case there's sensitive or private information in there. Click on it and drag straight across it. You can also use the sketch or drawing tools. You see them right here next to each other. That one's sketch, that one's drawing. When you use the sketch tool, it will attempt to refine your drawing. So if I were to draw a star like this, it would make it into a perfect star. And using the formatting tools to the right side of the markup toolbar, I can adjust the thickness of the lines or the color on the inside or outside of those drawings. But when you use the drawing tool, it doesn't correct it. It leaves it exactly as it is. So if I do a star here, that's what I get, the star that I drew. Let's go ahead and remove these items from the PDF. To remove anything that you add, all you have to do is click on it and hit the delete button and it'll disappear. And to the right of the sketch and drawing tool, you'll find the shapes tool, which will allow you to add lines, arrows, squares, circles, stars, all sorts of shapes that you might need to draw attention to a particular part of this document. On the lower left side of the shapes tool, you can add something that will allow you to highlight a particular section of the document. And you will also find a section that will allow you to add a magnification to a particular part of the document. Using the blue dot, you can make the circle bigger or smaller. Using the green dot, you can adjust how much it's zoomed in. And to the right of that, you'll see the text tool. The text tool is super helpful, especially for those PDFs that you're supposed to print out and fill out by hand. So let's close this document and open up a form document that needs to be filled out. The first thing we want to do is open up our markup toolbar here and click on our text tool. You'll notice that the text tool puts a big text right in the middle of our page. We can easily change the size and the format of that text by clicking on the text tool over here and simply changing it. We're going to make that a whole lot smaller and changing the color to black. And now I can take that text and I can drag it to wherever I need it to be. Once it's in the right position, I can easily double click to select it and type in whatever I need it to say. If you need to resize it, just grab the right or left side and drag it a little bigger, and then you can position it wherever you want it to be. And you can repeat this with any parts of the form that you need to fill out, simply clicking the text button, typing in what you need it to say, putting it in position, and going to the next spot on the document. And then to the right of that is my favorite tool of all, and the one you've all been waiting for, the signature tool. You see right here, if you click on the signature tool, you can insert a signature that you've already created or create a fresh one. Now, if you've never created a signature, this is super helpful because signatures created in Preview synchronize across all of your devices through iCloud. That means that if you use this function on your computer, then once you've created that signature, you can easily sign documents from your phone or iPad. There are several different ways you can create a signature easily right from here. Let's click the Create Signature button and play around with them. The first option, if you have a trackpad, you can simply use that trackpad to sign with your finger like this. And then click Done. And now I've got that signature. Or If you have an iPhone nearby, you can click on the iPhone option and it will open up a page on your phone that looks just like this that will allow you to sign with your finger from here. Maybe a little easier than doing it on your trackpad. And that signature gets added. But one of the easiest ways to add your signature is to simply sign a piece of paper with your signature, click the Create Signature button and the Camera button, and then hold it up to your computer's camera like this. And it will convert that signature into a digital file for you and make it available on any of your devices. Once you've successfully created your signature, you can add it to the documents very, very easily by selecting the signature tool and the signature that you want, and then moving it into place. And if you need to enlarge it, you can simply pull on the little blue balls here to make it the size you want to make it and position it exactly where you want it to be. If you've made a lot of adjustments to your PDF, I suggest saving a fresh version of it by coming to the File menu and selecting where it says Export as PDF. This will take all of your changes and flatten them onto the document to make sure that anybody who gets this document sees it with your additions, your changes, your signature, your markups, etc. So that's our lesson for today. Now, whether you're using Preview to just open a PDF, or to create a PDF, or merge multiple PDFs into one larger document, whether you're using it to edit or mark up existing documents, or even using it to fill out and sign a form that somebody emailed you that otherwise you'd have to print out, sign by hand, and scan back in. Now that you understand the capabilities of Preview, you can do all of those things easier, faster, and simpler. If you liked this video and you got great value out of it, hit that like button. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, go ahead and take a moment. Hit the subscribe button and the notify bell so that you'll always be alerted whenever I release new videos. I release videos weekly on Apple tips, tricks, tools, walkthroughs, and all sorts of other cool topics. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer, and I can't wait to see you next time.